Good morning, dear listeners. Today, we will study the story Weathering the Storm in Ersama. Actually, this story is penned by a renowned Indian writer, a writer who deals with the pathetic condition of the children in his writing. He is a columnist also, and his name has got a unique identity in the history of Indian writing. He is none other than Ersama. This story, Weathering the Storm in Ersama, we find the protagonist of the story is a boy named Prashant. Prashant is actually a young man, and the date has been given in the story. We find that is 27th of October 1999. After 7 years, after the incident that happened, and it was really unfortunate incident that his mother died. And after 7 years, the story talks about the setting that he had gone to a place named Ersama. Ersama is actually a coastal town in Orissa, and he had gone to the place to meet his friend, to spend a day with his friend. But this incident, this event happened to be really unfortunate one in the life of Prashant. What happened actually, that at the time of the evening, a strong storm approached. It was really a disastrous one. Trees started uprooting and people became horrified. Hue and cry was everywhere, and people started crying there. Prashant and his friend's family, they were horrified, terrified, and all the villagers also, the town area, that Ersama, the people of that area, they were crying due to the horror created by this storm. After 36 hours of this storm, the situation became worse, and it was going to be worse, as it was predicted, as it destroyed many living places there in that town, Ersama. What happened after that after 36 hours, when angry water waves started surrounding the residence of Prashant's friend, Prashant's friend's family members, they decided to take shelter on the roof, and they had gone to the roof. And after that, the storm took its most dangerous form. There, two coconut trees, fortunately, they had fallen on the roof. And those two coconut trees, due to those trees, they spent few days there, by eating it, by taking the advantage of coconut trees, they received the fruits, and they had eaten, because it was a disastrous situation downside. After that, what happened? Prashant was extremely worried. After 2 days, Prashant decided that he should move in the search of his family members, because he was also thinking about his personal life, that what about my family members. And I already told you that Prashant's mother had died 7 years ago, and it is written clearly that he decided to move in this, and in the story it is clearly written that he dared himself. All the family members were not agreed, his friend's family members, they were not agreed, but he decided to move because he had to bear his family members. So he took a very long stick in his hand, and with that stick he just moved for his 18 kilometers far away village, which was, the name of the village is also given in the story, Kalikuda. He started his journey, and after moving from the place, he found two friends of his uncle. they were with him and they cooperated, they helped him, and now three members, they decided to move towards his village that was Kalinga. Now they had what the situations were there in the way. In the way they had to push away so many corpses, so many dead bodies of the men, women, children also, and carcasses of dogs and cattle. So you can imagine what a disastrous that form of disaster it was. And finally, Prashant reached his village. When he reached his village, Kalinga, he found the condition of the village was extremely horrific. It was just to be predicted in the context of danger and the help only. And he just thought about it, that what he had to do, that he had to search his family members, and that's why he approached, he went to the place, and there was Red Cross Center, that he might get his family members. And when he reached there, that of their condition at the place, that Red Cross Center, the condition was very miserable. And when he went there, he met his brother, sister, his uncles and aunts. It happened. After that, when he met, he just listened the horrific stories one by one by each and everyone, and he also became very emotional. He started thinking as a young person. He became very helpful for them. He started thinking how could he help them. And then he also found out the truth that 86 people died in his village, and all the 96 houses that had been totally devastated, it means had been washed away totally, okay, due to the storm. This was the horrific situation of the village, and who will not be worried if such situation will happen, something to him or her personally. And he had taken it as a granted, he had taken it as a challenge, and that's why he decided to do everything for his villagers and for his people. And Prashant, what was the next step? Prashant just organized a team of youth volunteers that they should help the people in the shelter, and then this team of young members, they started helping the people there. And after when they started helping, they also noticed a military helicopter over their head, that it was in the sky and it was moving, it was hovering around, and they thought that this military helicopter must notice their condition. And that's why Prashant instructed the children that they must lie down and they must put the utensil on the stomach, that military helicopter must notice that they were hungry and they needed food packets. When it happened, now military helicopter sent the food packets for them, and then in this way they received the food packets. And Prashant helped the orphan children also, that the children whose mother and whose father they were missing, and they could not find their parents. So Prashant just tried to give them relief, and he just requested the women whose children were not there, whose children were missing. He requested those women to start working in the Food for Work program started by an NGO, non-government organization. So non-government organization it is. So Prashant just persuaded that women that you must work for them, and children also, and for the children, that how could they pass their time, how could they utilize their time. So they must be having an interesting time. That's why Prashant organized a kind of cricket team for them, sports event for them, and they started playing there. In this way they found themselves very interesting. So in this way the story ends with a positive note, that Prashant helped in every possible way to the women, to the children, and all the orphaned children were there. So he united all of them, and he worked as a leader of the village. At this young age, each and every one's responsibility is to do something for his village, for his near and dear ones. And Prashant in this matter, he seems an idol for each and everyone in the village. As far as we are concerned also, we must take responsibility for what happens to us. And if we do not behave as leader, he do not work like a leader. So who will give, who will set an example for others in the society? This is what, this is exactly what Prashant is doing for his village. And that's why this story gives a positive note to us, that with the just marathon effort of Prashant, the village once again became just totally settled. The villagers became totally happy and they started spending their time peacefully. Thanks a lot for listening. Thank you.